Welcome. Today is Sunday, December 27th. It is 9:04 p.m. Eastern, episode 257 of The Sundering. Ray is showing me the middle finger twice.
Yeah, not the chat room, just you.
Okay. This episode is brought to you by ads, Amazon, Newegg, Jinx, and Groupon. If you like the show or if you just plain like shopping, click through our links first. It's no cost to you, helps us out. And we just take a little bit back from the man. We appreciate it. Also, if you like what you hear, go out and drop us a review on iTunes and Stitcher. If you don't listen to us on iTunes, go drop us a review there anyway. If you don't listen to us on Stitcher, well, go and drop us a review there anyway. We'll love it. We read it. All that good stuff. We appreciate it. Helps other people find us. And, you know, what do we have on Duck Free tonight? Why? I'm just another reason to hate the arch enemy of my alma mater. We'll talk about that. We talk about urine as decoration or not, how not to use urine. Hasu has put in Battlefront news, which apparently he wants to find another reason to hate that game. So we'll cover that.
Quite funny, I'm sure.
He just does not like that game. So welcome to Sunder. We hope you enjoyed your Christmas. We hope you enjoy your work's Christmas party. We'll entertain you while you start your new job search.
The Sundering is an explicit podcast, which may not be suitable for children, people with delicate sensibilities, animals under 10 pounds, certain towns in Idaho, citizens of Liechtenstein, members of the clergy, fans of the show Cop Rock, and vegans.
The following program is closed captioned for the thinking impaired.
Well, let's start the insanity.
This is the Sundering Podcast with your host, Seraphis.
Self-replicating bacon. I don't like fat chicks cutting my hair because we wouldn't want it to get weird or anything.
Rapist.
He adds to the show and everyone gets upset. This is great.
I know. I know they say this, but I don't care.
And Zia.
Hi, Slurp. I'm so full of hate. I'm not sure what a podcast is. Slavery is different than a fish.
All right, so apparently I am loud and crackly, according to Broomfondle. I didn't think that I was, but I will...
am I loud and crackly?
I don't think you are.
That's what I want to know.
Anyway, I've lowered the volume of my mic, so we'll see if that helps.
My bird fell.
I mean, do I sound loud and crackly to you?
Not to me.
Oh, okay. Well,
everything sounds fine. I would let you know if you did. I got a bird on my head.
Well, anyway, good evening. I am Seraphis. I'm joined by my co-host, Ray. And we have a chat room.
Oh, we do.
Are you there? Do you have names?
I'm just updating the list, you know. It takes a while to update the thousands and thousands of names I'm going to have to read right now. Oh, wait. Well, apparently it didn't update. What the hell? It says I only have three, and we obviously have more than three. There we go. All right, so we got... Hasu and Velvet Dove, of course. We also have Adam. Was it Bordardo?
Bordardo.
Hastor, Kiwi Red, and Z, Opus Magnus, and Poikle Satin.
Wait, did you say Broomfondle in every class?
No, they're not. That's why I was confused. I was like, it didn't update. No, it didn't update. Go fuck yourself.
I mean, you go.
Oh,
fuck.
There we go. Broomfondle in every class.
Boom.
And by the end of the show, we're gonna have Twinblade Dan. It's almost a guarantee.
Robep one will pop in like, hey, everyone. And we'll be like, and we're done.
And we're done. Yep. See you guys later.
What a lovely canoe. Just go with it.
I was going to say, did you watch Nick Offerman drink whiskey?
No, I did not, but I heard about it.
I threw it on and my dad, he was laughing. And then he's just like, what, are you going to turn it off? I'm like, no! This is going to be funny. I just turned it off because we want to watch basketball.
Oh, yeah, that's a thing. So Ray, well, I'll just jump in. How was your holiday? We'll start with you.
A monster here, but...
People are already demanding Zia. Like, look.
Whatever. Listen, we can't control the fact that she spawned.
Not only that, she squeezed a watermelon out of her vagina. You know what that does to the nether regions?
Yeah, she has to take some time to, like, let everything kind of come back in or whatever.
I mean,
watermelon. Jesus.
Yeah, exactly. Jesus. That's.
You said it, man.
Nobody fucks with the Jesus.
So I'm.
What are you doing?
One of your gifts, actually, two of them. So Seraph got me things.
Yes, I did because you're my friend, and I feel like you deserve a few things.
This is true, and just so you know, I didn't get Seraph anything because I didn't know I was getting anything until the week of Christmas.
I only send you stuff like every year.
I know. Yeah, I know. I'm just saying, like,
I don't need anything from you.
If anyone sits there and wonders why I don't send things, listen to the show more often and realize the kind of shit I'm going through right now.
He's broke.
Yeah. Well, not broke. That's
okay. Once you move to Canada, exactly. I will expect Chili to supplement years of you not giving me gifts.
Yeah, we have a couple ideas for like a joke Christmas card to send to people, you but we're not gonna do it seriously.
Bitch.
It's just gonna be me, Spread Eagle, you know.
All right.
On like a Burt Reynolds rug, not like a bearskin rug, like a Burt Reynolds, Burt Reynolds. As a rug.
You can get a Wampa rug.
God damn it. Fucking Star Wars. Alright, so Seraph got me the League of Regrettable Superheroes. Oh, it's a loot... Oh, fucking... You pawned off a loot... I didn't even notice that till just now. You pawned off a loot crate thing to me?
Yeah, I did.
Loot crate edition? You fuck. Alright, so... The person that got the most enjoyment out of this was my dad, because it was underneath the tree, and he's like, what is that? And he started looking at it, and I, like, went in the bathroom, and I hear him laughing. He's like, I'm pretty sure I have one of these, like, comics in my old comic collection, so we're gonna look into that.
I mean, I looked through it, and I was just like, it really didn't do anything. I'm like, you know who would enjoy this? And random stupidity. Ray would enjoy
it. It's a nice shitter book.
There you go.
Just so you know, like, I will shit and read this.
Well, I do other like, things in the shooter. Miracle
Man. What does it say? Known relative. Oh, no, never mind. I was going to say if there's one, like, I could come in here and, like, quickly summarize, but it's kind of difficult to do.
No, because they're
Dr. Vampire. Yeah, they're all terrible. Not just regrettable, they're terrible. He got me a... This might have been in the loot crate, too, I'm guessing.
No, actually, no.
Attack on Titan keychain. I'm pretty sure it's Levi from Attack on Titan.
I have no idea. All I know, angry. I just saw this box that said Attack on Titan, and I was like, it was like $6.99. I'm like, I'm grabbing one for Ray. So I told you how much it was, but whatever. I saw it and I grabbed it, and I was just like,
this thing. I was just okay. Like, first of all, if he's actually trying to give us chicken pox, I think everyone in my household had them already. I think my mom gave them to me when I was really little, and she felt really bad about it. I'm like, isn't adult chicken pox worse? Like, I remember hearing about that. Like, you would have chicken pox and you would have all the kids come over to get it. So then everybody would get it and then you wouldn't have to worry about it. At least that's what I thought.
So, yeah. So, plus chicken pox. Oh, yeah.
So you got a chicken pox thing. It's a little... It's bird. It's bird RP.
I got that for you because I was... So, my wife is going to have just some minor surgery, and they had to do some blood work and tests on her, and one of the tests was for STDs, and one of the things that they specifically called out was syphilis. And I was just like, my wife's like, I'm pretty sure I don't have syphilis. And they're like, yeah, but we still have to do blood work and tests for it just in case. And so, the joke was that she's like, if I have syphilis, she looked at me, she's like, you gave it to me. And I'm like, what? So I was trying to find, like, a plush thing of syphilis to give to her. And then I just happened to run across chickenpox. And I was just like, Ray would like this.
Yeah. It's definitely one added to my collection of really weird stuff.
So.
And I got... Okay, so that was Sarah's gifts. I don't think there was anything else.
No, that was all I sent you.
I always...
Hopefully it was good.
Oh, it was... Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you. My dad got me a Bose Bluetooth speaker, but I left mine at work, so I'm showing you his right now. Mine's red. Well, I work tomorrow, so it's not like a big deal.
Look, Velvet says she loves plushy diseases.
Yeah, and I don't have one of these in Canada, but I always use it at home. It's to cook thing like pizza on in the oven. It's just a nice metal tray. So we have one for Canada now.
Canada.
And just in case somebody wasn't here last week and wants to see these fucking awesome shit kicks.
Jesus H. Christ. Yeah, these shoes.
Look at them. Look at them.
You know, it's like University of Florida colors there.
Not really.
If you blue and orange.
If you got rid of the... Well, I guess so. Whatever. No one up here cares about fucking Florida.
Go Gators. Do the chomp.
Yep. Fucking whatever. I think that was all that way, but then I thought that my friend Dan had gotten me the Aviary Attorney. it's a bird game on Steam. I'm just going to read the synopsis of it because it's very telling. Excuse me. The hottest bird lawyering game to come out of the 1840s France. Join J.J. Falcon and his witty apprentice,
J.J. Falcon,
as the two take on clients, interview witnesses, collect evidence, and deliver justice to the guilty.
Only if it's indiscriminate justice.
I don't know. Sarah keeps on saying that. it's 12... What was it? Is that 12 or 17? I think it's 1274 right now, and I'm considering getting it just because I can do a gameplay of it. Because if I do a gameplay of this, that means Sarah has to do a gameplay of his Christmas present.
From Toasty.
So I guess I don't think I did anything else this week, because I kind of want to go into that.
You want to go into that?
Into what you got from Toasty. I think we talked about at the end of the show last week, but not during the actual show.
Yeah, I don't remember much about Festivus.
What, you fucking hammered?
I don't know, maybe.
Well, what did I play? God damn it. I played something, and it's bothering me. Oh, Tabletop Simulator. I was messing around with that again. And if anyone's ever heard of HeroScape, we used to play that here, when back in... 2005 or 6 or something like that. We got five or six of us together. We play in my basement, and it's really fun. You build a level. It's like a hexagon, little tiles you can make, and what is it? The height of the terrain matters in advantage of shooting and stuff. Like instead of 2 attack die, you get 3 attack die or something like that. So it's really cool, but. They got one of those on Tabletop Simulator, and it was very, very difficult. Everything was in bags, and in order to empty the bag, you had to click and fucking fling out of the bag, and there was 30 or 40 bags. I'm like...
It sounds ridiculously stupid.
Yeah, but I mean, I kind of got the hang of how to use Tabletop Simulator, so I'm hoping someday we can do something with that, maybe play Cards Against Humanity, as much as that game kind of... bores me, but I would play.
No, there's an online version of Cards Against Humanity that we could play.
I know, but I'd rather have a flip a button to be able to flip the table.
Oh, there's a button to do that?
Jesus Christ, yes. Huh. I didn't know. I'm surprised you didn't know that.
No, well, I mean, I have Tabletop Simulator, I just haven't installed it.
Yeah. Well, install it so we can mess around with it someday.
Take
space. So I think that was about it. I was just messing around with that, so. Sarah, what did you get for Toast?
So, for those of you who don't know, Toast, or I'm not sure if I, yeah, I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but Toasty, one of our awesome listeners, sent me a game that we were joking about called Shower with Your Dad Simulator on Steam. So, that game I have now, and I told my wife that I have it, and that people wanted me to do a playthrough. And she told me that I should, so...
You can't deny the missus her wants and desires.
I guess...
That being one of them.
So I have that. What else? So for the holiday... been doing the Warcraft Wintervale stuff. Have a whole bunch of the Wintervale directions up in my garrison. Got the mount, and... Pretty much called it quits after that. And, oh, by the way, I am drinking tonight a magic hat. It's called a snow roller.
How's that?
It's pretty good. It's a hoppy brown ale.
I used to drink a ton of magic hat, so I remember.
Let's see, I've been playing a ton of Heroes of the Storm, just earning a ton of gold. Getting basically all the heroes I can up to level 5 to get that 500 gold, and doing all my dailies, and buying heroes that way, and I have a whole bunch of new podcasting equipment. I tweeted out a picture of it. I'm just trying to set it up. I have pretty much the mic set up properly, but I can't get the other pieces to work right with the soundboard and everything, so I need to keep playing around with that before I do a full switchover of the current setup to the new setup. But it's really cool because I got this like pneumatic arm thing, so like my mic is like up here. My new mic is like up. I'm like pointing, but you can't really see it. But it's like up there, like up above. Well, here, my
I'll
desk.
Show. I'll show everybody, Sarah. If I can show everybody what you mean, watch.
Yeah, it's kind of like that, except it doesn't look like there's an eyeball coming off of it.
Well, it's because I have the snowball. What are you gonna do?
Anyway, so I have that. I got a new Razor Death Adder mouse. So I have a Razor Death Adder, but the cable on it has been, I've had it for like 5 years, and it's been like rubbing up against the back of my desk. So the braided edges are starting to wear off, so it's starting to expose the bare wires. So I got a new one of those. And my wife, I posted a picture of this on Twitter also. She got me the exercise, and it says exercise, and then it says eggs are sides, and then it says eggs are sides for bacon. Bacon. So that's the shirts I have. And I really like it. I'm trying to find a picture of it. Here we go. I'm going to post a picture of this bad boy in the chat room, but basically this is the shirt. That's basically the shirt that my wife bought me. So I'm really excited about that. Let's see. What else happened? Oh, so I went to my in-laws for Christmas dinner. My sister-in-law was there. We got into a disagreement about salad dressing, at which point she started going around telling people behind my back that I hated her. We had
family drama.
Here was the deal. I said, you know, my go-to ranch dressing is Hidden Valley Ranch. And here's what she said. She's like, I like to make my own using Greek yogurt. I'm like, that seems like a lot of work. I'll stick with the Hidden Valley Ranch. That was the end of the conversation. That was it. That was literally it. That was the whole conversation. And next thing I know, my wife is like, why do you hate my sister? I'm like, what? She's like, she's going around saying that you hate her. I'm like, she's serious? She's like, she was dead serious. I'm like, we had a disagreement about salad dressing. Like, how does this happen? I don't even know what to say about that. Yes, see, little dove, it's a tad extreme. Salad dressing. Though my sister-in-law can be a little bit of a narcissist, so but I think everything was all good towards the end there. But yes, had to scream about that. My other sister-in-law, the one who like lives in town here, her and my brother-in-law bought me a 12-pack Sam Adams winter lager for Christmas. So I'll accept that. What? That's a good gift.
I know, I miss it. I miss the winter lager.
Oh, my brother-in-law, the one who lives in town, me and him, we killed a whole bottle of bourbon when we were up at the in-laws. So that was something. And that's...
I just saw this fucking thing. I only say it because it has Superman and Batman in it, but it's one of those things that says you wake up as Superman, what's the first thing you do? And the first guy says, go back to sleep and hopefully wake up to be Batman. I just thought it was funny. And Sarah's just like, oh, Ray's talking and saying stuff. I'm going to look at the screen and not say anything.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you don't.
But yeah, so that's pretty much the rub of it. That was my holiday. kids had a good holiday. They had fun. They enjoyed themselves, and that's about it.
That's good. I mean,
I did take the kids to go see Star Wars Episode 7, and it was good stuff. Every time the X-Wings and the TIE Fighters would fight, my son would be like this. Mind you, my son was two. The movie was probably about 20 minutes too long for him. He started getting a little antsy towards the very end, so that was a little...
What movie's too long for people is the fucking new Tarantino movie.
Now that it's been
leaked by a rival company, I think, people are watching it and then complaining about it. Oh, it's too long. And it's just like, you just watched a movie for free. Shut your face. I'm still waiting till the theater, but I cannot wait. I was tempted, but I can't do it. It's like the one time I'm like, I go to see this guy in the theater every time, so...
Huh.
Kind of want to make sure. Yeah, so it's like two hours and 40 minutes if you see the released like next week one, but the one he's doing now in like the special 70mm film is like 3 hours long. And it has an intermission.
Wait, The Hateful Eight, right?
Yeah. Because he's doing a release from Christmas to New Year's of... in only select theaters that have the ability to do the 70mm film, which is what he originally wanted it on. So you can actually probably go see it because you live in a, you know, near a cooler area, I guess.
Near a cooler area. All right. Well, I'm kind of in a college town where I'm at, so.
Oh, me too, but I don't live near Atlanta. You know what I mean? Like, you can probably find something that has that. But I mean, I'm still excited. I cannot wait. Like, it'll probably be 2 weeks before I can give a review of it, but I will probably have seen it twice by then. If it comes here, like if it comes to Olean, that's what I'm hoping. Cause a lot of times his movies just don't show up because they're like, oh, we're going to have like fucking four screens for Star Wars. Understandable. But then they have some stupid fucking like Katy Perry movie or like One Direction movie that takes up a screen. It's fucking nonsense.
Or Magic Mike 3.
Listen, Magic... As we all know, there's no bigger fans of Magic Mike than Seraph and I.
All right, let's get into some news.
And now I want to hear some bullshit that happened somewhere.
All right, folks, so the time is running out to get your photos in. For our contest, December entries are coming to an end on the 31st at 11 p.m. Eastern. So get those in there. Current is an Amazon $10 Amazon e-gift card, but then we're going to be drawing for the big prize pack on our January 10th show. So you still have a little bit of time to get in all the extra pictures in. To get entered for, I mean, you get 60 days of Warcraft game time, $20 Jinx gift certificate, Warcraft mount of your choice, Battle Pet, $20 Battle.net gift card, and a $20 Steam card. Lots of stuff going on. Definitely go and,
Do it.
Get those pictures in. You have a chance. Toasty, I will say, is currently in the lead. He is in the lead for the big annual prize pack. But anyone can easily catch up and tie him and in the time given. So good luck. Let's see. Remember, our December themes are winter holiday gifts, friends, and family. Last week, during our Festivus show, we also announced a short contest to win a $20 Battle.net gift card. And you just had to email us and say that you wanted it. And I would like to say we randomly selected a winner from all the emails we received. So I want to say congratulations to Chris W., we will be emailing you your $20 Battle.net gift card code. So congratulations to you. That's good, right? You could buy more heroes or pets or Game Time or something. Right? Yes? No?
Yeah.
Frey doesn't give a shit.
You're the guy that does the giveaway stuff. I'm just here for my looks, you know.
All right, let's get into the bacon news.
Bacon.
All right, folks. There was a tragedy. There was a truck carrying 2,000 piglets, and it overturned. Ray's trying to ignore this.
I had to adjust my hat. Shut up.
But yeah. Basically, thousands of piglets. It was a chaotic scene. Some piglets were seriously injured.
Well, yeah.
I mean, these are pigs that could turn into bacon. And we may have lost some bacon. This was a tragedy.
Sarah doesn't actually care about animals. He just cares about the animals that get him bacon. Not that, like, oh.
Well, why else would we be transporting piglets? It's not because, like, it's like, oh, you know, we're going to take them to Disney World. They weren't taking them to Disney, Ray.
Maybe it is to them. You just don't know it.
You're an idiot. You're an idiot wearing an orange beanie.
That you picked out because I asked you, should I wear that one or the green one?
And you listened like an idiot.
Hey, I'm just putting one on. These headphones fucking hurt my ears.
Still an idiot. Anyway, so we lost some piglets. It's a shame. I would pour one out for my homies, but I'll just drink one for them instead.
It's waste.
And I did have bacon this evening to mourn some of their passing, and pray that we get more piglets soon. Yeah, see, Vish is like, oh god, the piglets. She is thinking, and Haster is saying that he could not save the piglets. And I wish that you could save the piglets, Haster, because you would have been a hero. And I don't use that term lightly, but...
No, I'm not going to drink one for those doing Dungeon Finder. You chose that life, not me. That's not our problem. That's what I'm saying.
All right.
You press the Q button, okay?
All right. So let's hit on this other story here.
We're going to hit on it.
Baby. Fuck you, Ray. So I can
see you in my jeans or what the fuck? Oh, I can see myself in those jeans. That's right.
Those pants are very becoming of you, but of course, if I was on you, I'd be coming too.
That's so funny. That one's like crossing a line, I think.
Is it?
Yeah. I think if you say that one.
Is that like a Bukkake come on?
Did you just like threaten to come on me? Is that what you said?
You're going to give him the cummies.
That's my ears protesting.
All right. So for many of you who know, I went to Georgia Tech. I'm a Georgia Tech alumni. Well, the people... And we don't get along with UGA. UGA is our arch rival. Well, apparently, the University of Georgia decided to do some research and said that people who geek out over Star Wars video games or even Dungeons & Dragons are more likely to be narcissists, and they developed a geek identity scale.
Oh, boy.
So, I would like to point out that this is just another reason that I really do not like UGA.
Did you pick this only because it's fucking the Bulldogs?
No, actually, Hasu, our producer, found this article and put it in here, and I read it this evening, and I was like, holy crap.
Because I thought this was going to be one of those things, because I always confused that I was like, oh, Georgia's doing good, and you're like, I like Georgia Tech, goddammit. Like, oh, that's right.
So a few things you need to know. One is there. You could probably find UGA and Georgia Tech like football signs and search online. But there's been signs that some of them have held up like at football games where UGA was like Georgia Tech students like to read. We're like, okay.
Well, hey, I mean, thank you. I know some people that fucking hate reading.
They also said, like, Georgia Tech is nothing but a bunch of geeks. We're like, that's right. Okay. Still not really hurting us. Georgia Tech students always like to hold up a sign that says starting salary for a UGA grad, $36,714. Average starting salary for a Georgia Tech grad, $65,700 or whatnot. So it's like a magnitude of like 2x. That there's a difference. And yeah. So there's no love lost between UGA and Georgia Tech. And I'm kind of wondering if UGA just did this because they really hate Georgia Tech. But yeah, UGA and Georgia Tech are not fans of each other. And
most, what is it, University of State and then University of State Tech, they usually don't get along.
So, there you go.
Like Michigan and Michigan State. I mean, I guess that's Texas and Texas Tech.
There's also,
I guess it doesn't really work.
there is a running joke among Georgia Tech alumni, and it's what does a UGA grad call a Georgia Tech grad? Boss.
What? All right, we get it.
All right, let's move on. So this next one, it's kind of disgusting, but a 69-year-old woman from Indiana caused $3,000 worth of damage to her neighbor's home when she repeatedly threw urine
at it. I love the repeatedly part.
Which,
she had to go up and go and get more.
She reportedly collected this urine in a mop bucket.
Oh, yeah. Piss mop bucket. It's a piss bucket now.
And the funniest part of this is when asked why she did it, she said, "I don't like him, he's a bad neighbor." Completely disregarding the fact that she's the one throwing piss on his house.
Sarah, what happened before this? That's what I want. What drove this woman?
I don't know.
Like, maybe he was pissing on her house, and she's pissed that she can't do it. Maybe she should get one of those things that she could fucking, like, piss out of, like a guy. Maybe that was her thing. Like, he would get drunk, and he would be outside pissing, and she'd be like, "I wish I could do that." And she saw it every night for like 30 years, and now she's just like, well, I didn't know those things existed, so she was just pissing in a mop bucket. That's weird. I don't know, I'm just making shit up.
Apparently, like, the neighbor, like, set up a camera and filmed her throwing piss at her, at his house. So, apparently, she also initially denied it.
What? No, it wasn't me. Just like, well, it smells like your piss.
And apparently she was doing this all summer long.
Oh, God. So it was like baking on there.
So
just baked piss.
Apparently her piss had corroded the siding on the home. She faces up to a year in jail.
Just a year for making things all pissy? God damn.
Yep.
I've never gotten that mad at somebody to want to piss. Like, I'm like, I wouldn't collect piss, let's just say. Like, there have been, you know, customers I wouldn't mind pissing on their doorstep, but I'm not gonna go back with a mop bucket full of piss.
Now, I have filled a Super Soaker with piss before when I was like a young lad.
So gross. Ugh. I actually didn't know anybody that did that. We weren't really pissy kids. I guess you were.
I was pissed off.
Oh, I get it. I see what you did there.
Yeah, but I'm not quick enough on the rim shot right now. Alright, so gaming news. So our producer has to, I think he has a personal vendetta against Star Wars Battlefront. Because apparently they have announced that there will not be any Force Awakens DLC.
Well, yeah, that makes sense.
So Battlefront is meant to take place between episodes 6 and 7. Including some battles, I think, anywhere between like 4 and 5 and 5 and 6 as well. But nothing that's going to add in stuff between for episode 7. Yeah, he says the no single player thing really irked him. So
I think it hurt their like when they just came out and said like nobody plays it and we want to focus on what people mostly play. It's like that may be true, but there's also people that want to play a game by themselves. I mean, what 90% of my friends that game are like solo gamers. Like they play Fallout like all the fucking time and like nothing else. So if there was a campaign, they would have played that. They probably would. I know three people that would have gotten that game if there was a campaign. Seriously, not including me. Not me though.
I mean, I got the game. I'm still waiting for you to get it.
I don't know, man. I just don't feel like it's going to be worth it.
You told me you were going to get it.
Well, that's before I played it, and I was just like, man, this is underwhelming. I don't know. Maybe I'm changing as a gamer. Ugh. I'll look into it.
But I bought the companion app on my iPad, so like when I'm on the toilet, like I'll play it, and I'll earn credits through that app for the for in-game to buy stuff.
That's right. I need to see how much money I have. Oh. I'm just like I did say I would buy it, so I should look into it at least.
So anyway, so maybe the next game that they come out with will focus on episodes 7 and 8 or 7 to 8 or. Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Let's see. Also, Diablo 3 Season 5 unveiled. So that is coming. They are ending Season 4. So, Ray, remember Season 4? I helped power level you.
Yes.
So you can get your stuff in Heroes of the Storm. Well, we're getting some stuff. We're getting Hodrick's Gifts, which are special set pieces that players will receive throughout the season through the complete set. Though the complete set would be rewarded after the completion of Chapter 4. So you have to complete Chapter 4 of the season. New conquests have been added, so players can look for something new to do. And there's also going to be new cosmetic rewards. So a whole bunch of kind of the same old stuff, but also some slightly new stuff. The armor sets, I'm not like ultra jazzed about any of them. They don't really do anything for me.
Cosmetic stuff isn't really. I mean, none of those games, I don't play any of them enough to care, I guess I should say.
There
I got
is,
what I want.
It does look like you can get like a pet that looks like Groot. So that's something.
Ooh.
Hmm.
Yeah, I don't know. I played it a little bit, I think, without you. Like, but 90% of my playing has been with you, basically. So, I'm lost without you, basically, Sarah. That's what I'm trying to say. So I'm lost.
The other interesting thing is, they have this thing called Season Rebirth. So you can take one of your non-seasonal characters and transfer them into a seasonal character, but they're stripped of all their gear.
Hmm.
So I'm kind of considering doing this for my monk.
That would be cool.
So, I mean, I'd already have,
I'm not sure what that means, by the way. I don't...
You just had, like, a max level character ready to go, but you'd have, like, no gear for him, so... It might be just a quicker way to just start rolling.
Yeah, keep rolling, like that song.
Keep rolling, rolling, rolling.
Mm-hmm.
All right. By the way, in Season 5, it's going to be starting January 15th. It's a Friday for those of you.
Aw, shit.
There you go. That is it for our gaming news. So... We want to take this time. Usually, we like to do a quick predictions for 2016.
That's true. We do.
Hey, it's Toasty. Look at him.
It's Toasty.
By the way, Vish also joined, so we've had a few more people trickle in.
I was yelling at Vish earlier.
Dungeon Finder.
The Dungeon Finder thing.
All right. So predictions for 2016. All right. So gaming. So, best game of 2016. So, we're going to do a little mark the tape here. So, Hasu, get ready to start writing this stuff down.
Mark the tape.
All right. So, we got to decide on best game of 2016. So, Ray, why don't you pick? What do you think will be the best game of 2016?
Well, I think since you have more of them to talk about, you should go first.
Well,
all right. I kind of just picked one because I don't really know.
So I think. So I feel like we're gonna have to go with Metacritic, whatever their Metacritic score is.
This is totally just repeating what I heard today, but somebody, I just was listening to something. It's like, we're gonna play the worst games according to Metacritic, and the guy just goes, Metacritic. They don't even play games. They're a website. made me laugh, but go ahead.
All right. So, I've been debating. Like, is it going to be, like, No Man's Sky? Is it Final Fantasy VII Remastered? Will it be Overwatch? Will it be Legion? I'm going to say No Man's Sky will be the best game of 2016.
Is that only for PS4?
It's going to come out on PC eventually.
Oh, okay. Well, I was going to say, it looked like I wasn't going to be able to play it, so I was going to say I don't give a shit about it, but if I can eventually play it, that'd be cool, because I keep on hearing cool things about it. The whole randomly generated stuff. Yeah. Personally, from just hearing all the hype surrounding it, how much people are enjoying just the beta of it, that's Overwatch. Like, that's probably going to be the biggest game of the year. It sucks. I mean, I don't know. When is it supposed to come out? I don't even remember now.
I don't. Damn it.
Because it kind of...
Someone in our chat room will probably get it before.
Yeah, I know. Did they pick a game of the year for this past year? Like,
oh, they said Overwatch will release on or before June 21st of 2016. So there you go.
It's possible. I kind of feel like games that are... like later in the year probably have a better chance, just like movies, unless it's like a blow away, like this movie's so amazing that it's gonna win the Oscar or whatever.
But yeah, but will Overwatch do it with no single player?
I don't know. I mean, I just hear people enjoying the shit out of it, so I would assume that, as far as I know, because No Man's Sky is kind of is a mystery still. No, there's not much out there about it. So, and Legion, I don't feel like it's gonna. I don't know. We'll see.
So far, I'm enjoying the alpha. But just overall from a Metacritic standpoint, I'm going to say it's probably gonna be No Man's Sky.
Yeah, if it's Metacritic, yeah, probably that, or some weird indie game nobody's ever heard of.
All right, let's go to movies. So, best movie of 2016, and there's going to be a lot of them. And we should probably go with best blockbuster movie. It's like
big blockbuster. Yeah, like the summer movies.
Yeah. Let's not pick like one of those like indie ones. So like we got to pick like one. So the big blockbuster movies of 2016 that we know of: Independence Day 4, Resurgence, Rogue One. Superman vs. Batman, Captain America, Civil War, Suicide Squad, Warcraft. I think that's all the big ones that are going to come out next year.
Hmm. Well, Independence Day, that's a big who gives a fuck. But nostalgia, people will be like, ah, this is going to be so cool. Yeah, whatever.
It's Jeff Goldblum.
I know, he's a good actor. Rogue One, that's a Star Wars one, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I know nothing about that one.
That's, so if you remember in episode 4, New Hope, they talk about, like, a team had to steal the plans for the Death Star, and many people died to get these plans to us.
Ah.
That is what it is. That is Rogue One. Rogue One is the team that stole the plans for the Death Star.
All right, so my prediction, it'll be better than Force Awakens.
Wow, you think so?
Yeah, well, from the one person that I trust, I got a meh about Star Wars.
Oh, that's right. There'll also be Deadpool. I forgot Deadpool will also be out.
Ooh. So, Marvel is really good.
Oh, and X-Men Apocalypse.
Okay, so... that's the other one. Marvel's really good with their movies. Like, Superman versus Batman, I'm like... we'll see, I guess. I don't know. But Suicide Squad, I can see being good. Like, I can see that being, like, top two comic book movies of the year.
All right, so out of this list, ID4, Independence Day 4, Rogue One, Superman vs. Batman.
Let's get rid of ID4.
No, it's one of the big summer blockbusters. We gotta keep it in there. So, Independence Day, Rogue One, Superman v. Batman, Captain America, Suicide Squad, Warcraft, Deadpool, X-Men Apocalypse. Oh, is the new Star Trek also coming out?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so, and Star Trek. All right, and we'll add Star Trek in there. So, that's it. So, I think that's it for the big movies that are coming out next year. Out of those,
I think,
per Rotten Tomatoes score, which one will be the best one?
Rotten Tomatoes. Either Civil War or Suicide Squad. Or I can see Deadpool.
Maybe. Pick one. Which one's going to have the best Rotten Tomatoes score?
I'm going to go Suicide Squad. I'm going to say DC pulls it out this year.
All right.
Where's that Green Lantern sequel I've been waiting for?
I really want to say Rogue One. But I'm going to go ahead and say Captain America Civil War will be the highest rated one.
I wrote down Civil War, by the way, but I talked myself out of it.
All right, so out of those, I'm going to say Captain America Civil War. So,
yeah, because I've been waiting for that storyline to come to a head, and like now it is. I'm like, ooh, it's exciting.
Vish in the chat room says it's going to be Warcraft or Star Trek. I don't know about those picks.
Okay, so if you want to go worst, Warcraft will be the worst on Rotten Tomatoes out of all those movies. Or Independence Day.
Yeah.
I can't. But personally, like out of all those movies, I'll see all of them before I see the Independence Day. I will say that. Unless Rogue One. Well, no, Rogue One won't be.
Rogue One is for Christmas time next year.
I was thinking Rogue One, as long as it doesn't have anything to do with the other Star Wars movie, because who knows if I'll see it. So.
All right, so you say Suicide Squad. I'm going with Captain America. We'll see which one at the end of next year.
Just once they come out, I mean, we'll kind of know
the right
census by then.
So random just thoughts for 2016. I wanted to throw this out there. Here's what I'm thinking. 2016, and I'm not saying whether I like this or not.
We never bring our personal politics into this.
But I am going to just throw this out there. This is a random guess, is that Hillary Clinton will become president. She will have an affair. And then she will have a news conference and say, "What do you think of that, Bill? This was the long payback."
I'd be more interested in politics if that happened. I will say that. I say that I am. I'm trying to think. It's almost depressing, but I will say that I will be here a lot. I will be here in these states next year more than I will in Canada.
Wow.
And that's depressing.
That is depressing.
I hope that's not true.
But I'm hoping you get to Canada soon.
Yeah. We'll see.
All right. And then finally, we're going to do some BlizzCon predictions. I am going to say that it'll be the weekend of November 4th and 5th.
I'm going to say it's going to be in mid-October.
All right, fair guess. And
it's not a fair guess. It's literally me just throwing something out there just to see if I'm right. I don't know.
All
right,
and what do you think will be any big reveals at BlizzCon 2016?
God, I can't even think of it. Oh yeah, Warcraft 2. They're finally gonna World of Warcraft WoW 2, I should say. They're finally gonna make a game that's not outdated.
I'm gonna play it safe and say Diablo 4, or Diablo 3 expansion.
Yeah.
So, playing it safe. All right, let's get into some FOFs.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! You're cool. Fuck you!
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 Fuck you, Saddam Hussein of Iraq.
All right, Ray, what do you got?
I didn't have a FOF before when we started the show, but then I remembered something that I heard at work today that I was just like, oh man, this is going to infuriate me and probably other people. This whole $15 an hour like wage hike that like, you know, fast food workers and shit are trying to like get done. That's great in like the bigger cities and everything. Like, that's fine. But like, the way we're, I think we're getting our minimum wage in New York State increased. I don't even know what it is. It's getting increased though at the start of the year. And our owner was already kind of like, you know, like planning for that to happen and like kind of bracing himself to make sure he can, you know, keep in business because it's not that great right now, let's just say. So if we wind up at the $15, like, I would lose my job. And like, people just don't understand this. Like, yeah, maybe for like a giant corporation that has corporate stores like McDonald's, let's say.
Well, even McDonald's is franchised.
I'm saying if they, because some places are legit corporate stores. Like, I'm just not saying like my specific place, I guess, but for the franchisees, it's gonna suck. Like, just it's a little under double what, you know, we make. So it's like, oh, and then he's going to have to increase the prices, which people already freaked the fuck out about. What? A pizza's that much? It's like, ugh. Yes, wages go up, prices go up. Deal with it. But I just stop asking for $15 an hour. Like, at what point? I mean, you're doing the... I'm not saying you don't deserve more money. Because obviously, I know how it is to work minimum wage. You do deserve a little bit more. But you also need to think about all the other people that are, you know, business owners that are barely making it by. And maybe not ask for $15.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you have, like, five people and all of a sudden now you have to increase all their wages, like, it might be better off to let one person go and increase the hours.
Or just shut the fucking shit down, like, which is what will happen with this place and probably other places. I mean,
yeah, but like, no, I mean,
it's one of the poorest counties in the fucking like country.
No, so Vish, you're right. The minimum wage isn't a livable wage. You're right. But the problem that Ray brings up is that there's certain businesses that will say, I can't increase everyone's wages, so therefore I'm going to fire somebody and I'll increase everyone else, other people's hours. And because that will kind of work itself out, I have to raise prices as well.
Like, for me,
there are effects of this. And
in New York City, I can see it being a problem because you can't live off of minimum wage there. Like, it's impossible. Shit's expensive.
Oh, no, I agree. Look, no, I don't know how anybody lives in New York City. I don't know how anyone lives in California, to be perfectly honest.
Yeah. I'm just saying, like, that specific thing that people are asking for is legitimately, if that went through, I lose my job. And that's not even like me guessing.
All right.
That's a definite. And I'm not going to be here much longer, like in this country. So it sucks that I'm like, well, if that happens, at least I have that to go to. There's guys that like have been working there for 10, you know, 10 years, 10, 15 years that don't have much else they can do. They're like, I deliver pizza. I love it. That's what I do. I make, you know, good money. And that's what they do. And it's like, I'm just like, if that happens, like a bunch of my friends are going to be unemployed and it's going to suck. I mean,
yeah. So Vish brought up, she's like, economics true that the prices will probably go up, but it's all because of the inflation rate. Well, here's the problem. The inflation rate. I'm pulling up direct numbers. Inflation is really low. In fact, in 2011, the inflation rate was 3%, and then in 2012 it was 1.7%, then 1.5, and then 2014 it was 0.8%, and in 2015 it was only 0.5%. Because the inflation rates have been going down, this is why the Fed just recently increased the rates. So it's not inflation that's driving this up; it's just the cost of living is going up in certain areas of the country. And it's true, minimum wage rates in certain areas of the country are not livable. It's just not. But the fact is, if in order to cover, let's say, $15 an hour for pizza delivery, your $10 pizza now is going to go up to $15. That could be a deal breaker. And that could lead to business, like, what happens if you lose 20% of your business because they don't want to pay that extra $5 per pizza? Then all of a sudden, you start have to cut corners and start firing more people. And then people don't even have a wage. They have no wage.
I guess just for us, specifically, being in the state of New York, but basically living in Kentucky, area-wise, if you think about it. Like, we're in the middle of nowhere. Like, it's, you know, it's an hour and a half to get to Buffalo, and that's our biggest city that's near us. So I get why the Buffalo and New York City are asking for these things. I get it. And it's just that it's for us, this area specifically, it's going to wreak havoc. And I get, it's faff to that situation. I'm not faff. I don't want to sit there and act like that nobody should ever ask for that kind of money, because some places obviously need it. But just this situation, the fact that, like, the corporation that we work for kind of ties the franchisees' hands with a lot of things, and they have standards that you have to live up to with if you want to buy a new building, you have to spend fucking $75,000 to get up to the standards that they want for this specific year. It's rough. It really is. It's why I had a chance to buy that store numerous times, and I never did because I saw how you get treated sometimes. It's not worth it. And I'm not joking either. I've had Dan and I have both had a chance to buy that store at a discount. Like, it's just, we know it's not going to be worth it, especially with this stuff. So, all right. So that's my little faff slash we're having our little, what do you call it? Sundernomics.
Sundernomics.
Makes me think of that book, Freakonomics.
Sundernomics may be the show title.
That'll be easy to do. It'll just be, I'll put Seraph's face on, like, Alan Greenspan, Greenspan's face, or body.
He's not that's even a, part of it.
That's the thing. Last time I remember a fucking name in economics, okay? I didn't go to college that long, okay? Okay. I don't have a Georgia Tech degree, Seraph, okay? All right. I had a community college partial credits. I don't know if anyone knew that, by the way, that I didn't graduate college. Yeah, is that called graduating? Yeah.
Graduation.
Graduation. I didn't get a degree. I went to the school of hard knocks, as those guys on Monday Night Football say, that didn't go to college.
Anyway, so, but yeah, anyone who, yeah, I mean, changing minimum wage, like I said, I don't disagree with it. I agree that in certain areas,
and it's going up this next week too.
Like, but there's going to be impacts to the services, what those people provide, because
it'll be interesting to see what happens too if it does go through. Like, just in general, like, is somebody going to swoop in and buy this place? Who knows? It'll be cool.
Well, I'm more interested to find out the effects of goods and services as a result of this. That's what I really want to see. All right, so I have a whole bunch of props. So I'm going to say props to Corey. He sent me an Art of Blizzard book for the holidays. That was really cool. I just want to say props to D20 folks for supporting us and, you know, working with me to create ridiculous things and projects over the past year. It's been a lot of fun. And I want to prop Sia for squeezing a watermelon out of vagina, because now that vagina is wrecked, it's torn up.
That's what happens.
Props to Ray. Props to you, Ray.
What?
Because you're working to get your life in order, and good for you.
Yeah. Hell yeah, I'm working out too.
And I'm gonna say fav to stuff not working right, because I've been working for like hours trying to get this new podcast set up working, and it's just not. It's been not fun. Oh, and fav to my family who can't make decisions on. Like, so we had a decision that we were going to have Chinese food. Like, we were all going to come over to my house. We were going to watch movies and eat Chinese food. And they're like, I don't want Chinese food anymore. Let's just order pizza. I'm like, God damn it. I'm so sick of that as the go-to. No offense, Ray.
No, but, I'm just laughing at the chat room.
Also, I'm not sure whether I should, foff or prop Haster yet. For sending me a game on Steam just now called Who's Your Daddy? So apparently that is now a thing as well.
I love that you're just getting gimmick games with a certain thing. It has to have data.
At this rate, I'm going to get the aviary attorney before you do.
You better not. I want that game. I'll play it. I'll be fucking Captain Falcon or whatever his name is.
Lieutenant Falcon.
Yeah.
So yeah, there you go. So Sundernomics. Yeah, props to Sundernomics. Look at you. We're educational.
That's what we do over here.
All right, so some props and thoughts from the community. We got FuckPod said, who the fuck brings someone off leave for some stupid ceremony? So I guess he got brought off leave for a stupid ceremony.
Huh. That kind of, yeah, but thinking about that sucks. Like, yeah. I've always noticed that, like, ceremonies blow in general. Like, there's a ceremony? Yeah, I really don't feel like going. I'm already thinking about ways to get out of it.
You want to take the next one?
Sure.
All right.
I got to close my pictures of Alan Greenspan, but I'll do it. Let's see. Props to Rios Hill. Oh, this is from
Palmanis. Jesus Christ.
Sorry. Man. It's the color is what's throwing me off. It says props to retail workers for making it through yet another hell of a holiday season. It's not quite over, but the worst is. Then Priestess Fish says, foff to family drama, when Sarah was talking about family drama. And, oh shit, I thought she was talking about me for a second, but foff to immature guys who sexually harass women streamers. Well, that's not me, I swear.
So, I agree. I agree, Vish. But I also want to point out that if you are a girl streamer, don't put on your like stream that it's okay for guys to talk about your boobs. Because at that point, you're like, I've seen some of that. Like, I'm not saying it is okay to harass women, but as a female streamer, don't leave any doors open for these jackasses. Like, say, feel free to talk about my boobs. I know I got them and I love them and I'll jiggle them. And don't put that on your like about page thing. I've seen that and I'm just like, what? I'm like, no, don't.
Yeah, you gotta have some thick skin to deal with.
I mean, you're gonna have
male thick internet skin, goers.
Don't do that. Don't say that. That's just inviting assholes. And but you're already gonna have to deal with your own.
Can't do it. Can't play with them.
Ugh.
You know who I was quoting right there? Can't do it. Can't play with them.
Ugh.
Do you remember or no?
No.
What's his face? Singletary when he was coaching the Niners about Vernon Davis. It's like, can't do it. Can't play with him. Because he was like, I don't know. I forgot what it was, but it was funny. To me, at least. Anyways. What we got here?
Ooh, that worked perfectly. Toasty just sent me aviary attorney.
God damn it! I have to be somebody that would have to play. Gift it to me. Do it. Gift it. Gift it over this way.
Alright,
I'll actually play it.
But yeah, so to men and women, just be smart about how you stream and the rules you set up, and just make sure that you enforce your rules on your streams as best you can. And basically start locking that stuff down. Have good people sitting in your streams with you if you can, to help moderate. It's definitely helpful. I like that our chat room is self-moderating, but
yeah, sometimes we gotta lay the ban hammer down.
So, yeah. All right, so I think that is really it. That's it for the show. I don't even have a haiku prepared. I feel like you should stall.
Something about solo cups or whatever. Red solo cups, isn't that it? If you can make the Serku.
Well, that's Serku is like, yeah, you have to use the term red cups, but I'm trying to think of a haiku here, Ray, so I need you to.
Oh, okay. So what was I gonna say? I was listening to the Bleach official soundtrack because they had a thing of it on YouTube. I was listening to it at work, and like, it goes through every single like background thing. It's like 4 hours, so there's like intense music, like uplifting music. Then there's like sad violin music, and that was the one that kept on playing when this one guy would like come up and help us do pizza stuff. And then he was just like, "Are you just listening to sad violin music?" And I'm like, "No, you just happen to be coming up when it's playing." It's kind of funny.
All right, I got a haiku. So let's do the haikus now. Thank you, Ray.
Yeah, no problem. I just had to think of something really random right there. I got a gift!
Big titties and ass. She wants to be inside you. Haikus from Zia.
Do you got holes in the armpits of your shirt?
Oh, do I? Probably.
Jesus, Ray. Shirt. You got a holy shirt. You got a holy shirt.
I'm good for the night, okay? Like, it's not, I don't have to wear fucking nice things.
Alright, so here's my haiku. It's Sundernomics. Watermelon out of vag. It's completely wrecked.
I don't think I could do a show image that has a watermelon coming out of a vag. I just want that out.
I bet you could find that on the internet. Watermelon.
Don't doubt it!
Type in like watermelon vagina, do you find something?
You're gonna find out. I'm not.
Actually, someone carved a watermelon to look like a vagina. However, like, there's, you type in watermelon vagina and then you find a guy wearing a watermelon as a helmet.
Does his face look like a vagina?
No, it doesn't. So
Seraph Greenspan.
Seraph Greenspan. All right. So let's thank the chat room here. We got Hasu, Velvet Dove Adams, Room Funnel, Everclass, Kiwi Reds, Opus Magnus, Palamanus, Poikle Satin, Vish, Red Sniper, Shaw of Anger. Fuck yeah. Missed you, son of a bitch. I thought we left you on Pandaria. We got Toasty and we got Unique Bot. Oh. Unique Bot. That's unique and exciting.
Wait, is Twinblade Dan here?
No, he's not. I'm a little nervous.
What? Twinblade Dan? We have to stall the show until Twinblade Dan gets
here. Maybe he's Unique Bot. I don't know.
It's just like, I want to change my name today.
All right, Ray, where can people find you?
Well, if they have Twitter and they want to see the ramblings of an angry pizza guy, it's Rayfist. That's RAYFYST. And then Bird_RP as well. Also, I'm Rayfist on everything else like Xbox and Steam. So don't send me Bird Aviary Attorney because I already got it.
Did you really?
Thank you, Toasty. We'll have to have like a rival gameplay going on.
Is it multiplayer or single player?
Probably just single player, but I'm saying we can see who's the better lawyer or attorney or whatever.
It's so ridiculous. It's
so awesome.
Like bird law. It's not even like normal law.
Listen, bird law in this country is out of control.
Alright, you can find me on Twitter at Seraphis, Xbox Live, Amish Mafia, 2 words, PlayStation Network, Seraphis Prime, 1 word, Steam, I am Seraphis, Zia you can find on Twitter at ITSXIA, it's Zia. Mr. Hasu is our producer. Go follow him on Twitter. He is awesome. He has helped us out. He was on our Festivus episode last week. You can follow him at Mr._Hasu. You can follow the show. Our website is thesundering.net. You can find out all about our contest over there. Remember, you have 1 week left to get your pictures in for December to win a $10 Amazon gift card. Get something that you really wanted this Christmas instead of all the crap that you did get. Twitter, we're at TheSundering, Facebook.com/TheSundering. Go like our page. We are so close to getting to 200 likes over there. YouTube.com/TheSunderingPodcast. Go subscribe. We're going to put up videos and our video shows up there. So Follow that. We have a Steam group, so if you like hanging out with other people who listen to our show, and we have a Steam group called The Sundering, two words. Our phone number, 323-SUNDER-0 or 323-786-3370. Feel free to call us instead of one of your exes. We appreciate that. And you'll appreciate it, too. Email us at thesunderingpodcast@gmail.com. We are a member of D20 Catalyst, part of the D20 Crit Network. Our intro is courtesy of Boxing Fox. Check out more over at boxingfox.de. And thanks to everyone who submitted a FOF for our show tonight. We appreciate you. Once again, chat room, you have been awesome and a lot of fun. So fuck, download us, invite us in your home, your ears, your head. We just want to be inside you. Next time, we podcast from 2016. Motherfuckers.
'Shit, I could have made a fucking better episode.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.
I rolled a 20.